capsule heat shielding made of aerogel. I was reading about crew capsules and the re-entering into Earth's atmosphere. Since this generates loads of heat that the crew and capsule needs to be protected from, heat shielding is used. I read this is mostly made of aluminium with a ceramic coating. Please correct me if I am wrong. But then I thought, since the isolating properties and weight must be an important factor, why isn't this made from aerogel? Aerogel is extremely light, very isolating. So why is it not used? Has it todo with its brittleness, cost?
Aerogel doesn't have much mechanical strength. Orbital velocity is say 7,800 meters per second and you have to decelerate over say 300 seconds. Even if it's done carefully, there are 2 or 3 g's of peak deceleration. So imagine your spacecraft sitting on the ground resting on its aerogel heat shield with 2 or 3 more spacecraft stacked on top of it. It will likely be instantly crushed into aerodust. I don't know the details of the highest melting point silica gel possible, but silica aerogel is said to melt at 1473K or about 1100C, and that seems to be in the right ballpark, though a bit lower than the temperatures required for some areas of the space shuttle, for example. The heat shield also needs to be opaque to near-infrared light because the plasma sheath is really hot and radiative heating of the heat shield by the sheath is a big problem. Ablative heat shields generate a gas layer that is opaque to infrared, and ceramic tiles are opaque to this as well. If the aerogel was transparent to even the shorter IR wavelengths, then its thermal insulating properties wouldn't be so helpful. As velocity increases, both convective and radiative heating increase. At very high speeds, radiative heating will come to quickly dominate the convective heat fluxes, as convective heating is proportional to the velocity cubed, while radiative heating is proportional to the velocity exponentiated to the 8th power. Radiative heating, which is highly wavelength dependent, thus predominates very early in atmospheric entry, while convection predominates in the later phases. See also what aspects of reentry heating, scale is the 8th power,